Namaste. Welcome back to today's session. In the last class, we have discussed a new chapter, algebraic identities, and also we proved identity 1 through algebraically and also through geometrically. And we have come across how to apply the identity 1, which is a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, or a plus b whole square equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So today we are going to discuss identity 2. We are going to prove it by algebraically and also by geometrically. So the identity 2 states that a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square, or a minus b whole square equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. This is only the regrouping of the terms along with the sign. Anyhow, you can write it. So let me prove through algebraically. So first let us take LHS, which is nothing but a minus b whole square, which is nothing but a minus b into a minus b. In exponents and laws, we have learned what it is. X square is nothing but x into x, right? Or a square is nothing but a into a. Same way here, a minus b whole square is nothing but a minus b into a minus b. It's nothing but multiplication of binomial with the binomial. So the first term is a. This term is multiplied to this binomial a minus b. The one more term left out is minus b into a minus b. Now apply the concept of monomial with binomial. A into a, that is a power 1 into a power 1 is nothing but a power 2, that is a square, minus a into b is nothing but ab, because of different terms which we call it as unlike terms. A into b is nothing but ab, minus into minus plus b into b is nothing but b square, minus 1ab minus 1ab. These two are like terms. So when we have a like terms, we can add the terms. A square minus 1 minus 1 is nothing but minus 2ab plus b square, which is nothing but RHS. Hence, a minus b whole square is nothing but a square minus 2ab plus b square. So we proved algebraically. Now we'll go for geometrically. So here, to prove geometrically, I have taken one square sheet whose side measures a units. So the side of this square sheet is a units. Can you guess what is the area of this square sheet becomes now? So when you have a side a units and the side a units, then area of this square is equal to, yes, a square, because we know that area of square is nothing but side into side. Then a into a equal to a square. So the area of this square equal to a square, right? A square, square units. Now I'll take two rectangles whose length and breadth is a and b. So from here I'm going to take some units called as b units. So it is b units, and the length of rectangle is a units. Length of rectangle is a units and the breadth of rectangle is b units, isn't it? Yes. Then what will be the length of this part? What will be the length of this part? When the length of square is taken as a units and the length of this part is taken as b units, then the length of this part becomes a minus b, because a is complete length and b is this part. Then the length of this becomes a minus b. So the length of this part is A minus B units. So let me take the another rectangle and place it towards the down. Here, whose breadth is taken as B units and the length is B units and the length is taken as A units. So you can observe here, the breadth is taken as B units and the length is taken as A units. Then what is the remaining part from here to here? So the pura length was A units and this part is taken as B units. Then the remaining part is nothing but same as A minus B units. What identity we are going to prove? A minus B whole square. Is it nothing but A minus B unit and A minus B unit? The remaining part, is it nothing but a square obtained? Yes, because of same length of dimensions A minus B and A minus B. Then what is its area? Its area is nothing but A minus B whole square, because we know that area of square is nothing but side into side. Then here the side length is A minus B and here the side length is A minus B. Therefore, the area of yellow color, what we are seeing, that is yellow color square, is nothing but A minus B whole square. So let me find what is area by geometrically. So we'll fix all the rectangles. So what is this area, children? A minus B whole square is nothing but A square, that is complete square. Here one rectangle is removed, that is area of rectangle. Here one more rectangle is removed, but this rectangle is removed 2 times. Therefore, we are going to add the one part of square here, because in this rectangle this area is removed. But when we place this rectangle, again the same part of area is removing, means we are going to remove the square 2 times. So instead of that, we are going to add one square here. Therefore, A minus B whole square is nothing but A square, okay, minus AB, this part we are removing, minus AB, this part also we are going to remove. But since this part is removed 2 times, therefore we are going to add 1 time. That is, the length of this is nothing but B. The length of this is nothing but B, means it is a square. B into B, B square. So what is the area of this rectangle? A and B, we know that area of rectangle is nothing but L into B. So AB. Then area of this rectangle, A and B dimensions, is nothing but AB square units. This is AB, this is also AB. So the dimensions of this square is B units. Therefore, the area of this becomes B square, because since it is a square, B into B is nothing but B square. Now we'll get A minus B whole square. A minus B whole square is nothing but A square, that is area of big square, minus AB, this part is removed, minus AB, this part is removed, plus B square, because this part is removing 2 times, therefore 1 time we have to add it, as we have done in class 7 standard perimeter and area concept. So area of A minus B whole square is nothing but A square minus AB, because we are removing, minus AB, this part is also removed, plus B square. So A minus B whole square is nothing but, this area is nothing but area of big square, which is nothing but A square. Here one rectangle is removed, minus AB. Here another rectangle is removed, minus AB. Since this part is removing 2 times, therefore we should add 1 time plus B square. We know that minus AB is nothing but minus 2AB plus B square. Or for our convenience sake, we can even write A minus B whole square is nothing but A square plus B square minus 2AB. Keep remember, we are going to remove 2 rectangles. Therefore, don't forget to write minus 2AB. This is our proving of second identity through geometrically. Now, we'll go for worksheet 2. See children, same identity geometrically part, you have to do it in your classwork with the colorful papers. As I have shown clearly in the video, in the same pattern, you do it in the class notes. So the first main in the worksheet 2 given, find the following by using identity 2. Here it is specified identity 2, but in exam they will not give you. You have to use the suitable identity. So here there are 6 questions children. In this I'll do it only 4, and the remaining 2 you have to do on your own. So the 4 questions which I'm going to do are question 1, question 3, question 4 and question 6. So solution, the first question, x minus 7 whole square. This is in the form of a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Compare children here. Put a equal to x and b equal to 7. Please don't take minus 7 because identity is having minus sign. Even the question is also having minus sign. So when they are of same sign, take it positive. Then substitute these values in the identity. X minus 7 whole square equal to x square minus 2 into a value is x into b value is 7 plus again the b value is 7 square. Then x square remains as x square minus, multiply the numerical, 7 to the 14x plus 7 square. 7 square is 49. So here they are of unlike terms over. Further solution is not possible. So that ends first question solved. So second question solve same as the first question. Now let me move to the third question. 7x by 4 minus 2y by 3 whole square. Then a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Comparison, the value of a is nothing but 7x by 4. Since the sign is same, so b value equal to 2y by 3. Substitute in the identity, 7x by 4 minus 2y by 3 whole square equal to a square. A is nothing but 7x by 4 whole square minus 2 into 7x by 4, and b value is 2y by 3 plus b square. It's nothing but 2y by 3 whole square. Now equate the power to both, 7 square 49. Equate the power to variable also, x square, by equate the power to the denominator, 4 square 16 minus, since 2 can be written as 2 by 1, therefore you can go for cancellation, 2 ones are 2 twos, and this 2 with this 2, multiply all the numerators, 1 7s are 7, x into y is xy divided by 3 plus equate the square to all the factors, 2 square 4, y square is y square by 3 square is nothing but 9. Since the variables are different here, unlike terms, no addition, no subtraction. That ends the solving. So fourth question. Third question is asked you to do it. Fourth question. 8mn minus 2pq whole square. Then a minus b whole square is nothing but a square minus 2ab plus b square. Compare. The value of a is 8mn, comma. The value of b is, signs are same children, so need to be taken positive, that is 2pq. Now substitute these a and b values in the identity. 8mn minus 2pq whole square is nothing but a. A is nothing but 8mn. There are three factors, 8, m and n. Minus 2, a value is 8mn, b value is 2pq plus b square, that is 2pq whole square is nothing but 64 m square n square. Square should be equated for three factors, that is 8, m and n. So 8 square 64, m square n square minus, multiply all the numerical coefficient, 2 8s are 16, 16 2s are 32. All the variables are different, so keep it as it is, m and pq plus, equate the power to all the factors, 2 square 4, p square, q square, that's all. So fourth question over. Now we'll go to sixth question. So since the fifth question is in decimal, so let me solve fifth question also. The fifth question states that 0.1x minus 0.5y whole square. So a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now compare. The value of a is nothing but 0.1x, b 0.5y. So substitute 0.1x minus 0.5y whole square equal to 0.1x whole square minus 2. A is nothing but 0.1x, b is nothing but 0.5y plus b square is nothing but 0.5y whole square. Now equate the square to all. 0.1 whole square is nothing but 1 square is nothing but 1, but after point you have one digit, since 2 squaring you are going to do, so 2 digit, the point shifts before 2 digits. So 0.01, equate the square to the variable x square minus, multiply all the numerical coefficient, 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are 10. After decimal point, one number. After decimal point, one number. So 1 plus 1, 2 digits. 1, 2, point. So 0.10, variable xy. Plus 0.5 whole square. First you make square of 5. Square of 5 is nothing but 25. Then after point, one digit. Since 2 times, therefore 1, 2. 0.25. And square of variable is y square. That's all. Now we'll move to sixth question. A square minus b square whole square. So a minus b whole square is nothing but a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now compare. The value of a is nothing but a square, and the value of b is nothing but b square. Substitute in the identity. A square minus b square whole square is equal to a. The value of a is nothing but a square, but since you have square in the identity, therefore whole square minus 2 a is nothing but a square, b is nothing but b square plus b. The value of b is b square, and since the square is in the identity, so whole square. Now a square whole square, we know that a to the power of m to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of mn. Mn is nothing but multiplication, 2 2s are 4, minus 2 a square b square as it is, plus a to the power of m to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of mn, that is 2 2s are 4, that is b power 4. This is how first means solving. Now we'll move to second mean. Evaluate the following by using identity 2. Here they have specified But in exam, they will give suitable identity. Then you have to choose whether it is easy for applying a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. But here he told identity 2, we have to apply a minus b whole square only. So here there are total 6 questions. In that, I'll try to solve maximum. If they are easy, I'll ask you to do it as a homework in the classwork only. So solution, the first question is 48 whole square. 48 is a 2-digit number. Nearest to the 2-digit number is 50. Therefore, 50. For 50, what need to be subtracted to get 48? 2 should be subtracted. So, 48 can be written as 50 minus 2 whole square. Then apply a minus b whole square is nothing but a square minus 2ab plus b square. Then the value of a is 50. The value of b is 2. Apply 50 minus 2 whole square equal to a square is nothing but 50 square minus 2 a 50 b 2 plus b square. B square is nothing but 2 square. Then 50 square. Apply 5 square. 5 square is nothing but 25. 0 is only 1 time. Since it is a square, so you should write 2 times. That is 2500 minus, multiply all the numericals. 52 is 100. 100 to the 200 plus 2 square 4. So 2500 minus 200 is 2300 plus 4. That is 2304. If you do 50 minus 2, that is 48 square is nothing but 2304. Now we'll move to second question. The second question given is 9.9 whole square. So single digit, round off to the tens digit, that is nearest to 10. How to get it? Let me show here. 10.0. In that, what you have to remove? 9.9. So 10 minus 9 is 1 point. You have already taken. So 9 remains. 9 minus 0 is 9 minus 9 is 0. So around in 10, if you subtract 0.1, you will get 9.9. So 10 minus 0.9, 0.1 whole square. Then a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Compare, a value is 10, b value equal to 0.1. then 10 minus 0.1 whole square equal to a square is 10 square minus 2, a value is 10, then b value is 0.1 plus 0.1 whole square. 10 square 100 minus, you multiply all the numericals, 2 tens are 20, 21s are 20. Since after point we have 1 decimal, therefore from right side 1 digit, 2 plus 0.1 whole square. Make it as 1 square is nothing but 1. After digit you have 1 digit, after decimal point you have 1 digit, 2 times. So 2 digits, 1, 2.0. So 100 minus 2 is nothing but 98. 98.01. So the value of 9.9 whole square is nothing but 98.01. So third question. The third question is 299 whole square. So since it is a 3-digit number, that is 299 is a 3-digit number, closest to the 3-digit number is 300. 299 is nearer to 300. So in 300, if I subtract, what number do I get? 299, that is 1 whole square. 299 can be written as 300 minus 1. Then a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now substitute, a value equal to 300, b value equal to 1. Then 300 minus 1 whole square equal to a square nothing but 300 square minus 2 into 300 into 1 plus b value is 1 square. Further simplification. So further simplification, That is 300 minus 1 whole square equal to 300 square. 3 square, 9. 2 digits, 2 times. That is 4 digit minus 300 into 2. 600. 600 ones are 600 plus 1 square, 1. So, 90,000 minus 600 is nothing but 84,000. So, 90,000 minus 600 is 89,400. Yes, 400 plus 1, which is nothing but 89,401. What is 89,401? It's nothing but the value of 299 square. 299 square is 89,401. So now, fourth question, 98 square. So, two digit number, 98, nearest to the number 100, right? So, in 100, what number I have to subtract so that I'll get 98? 2. So, 100 minus 2 whole square. A minus B whole square equal to A square minus 2AB plus B square. Then the value of A equal to 100. The value of B equal to 2. Substitute in the identity. 100 minus 2 whole square equal to 100 square minus 2 into 100 into 2 plus 2 square. Nothing, children. The value of variables, whatever it is given, you need to substitute in the identity. Then 100 square, 1 square, 1. Since you have 2 digits, squaring becomes 4 digits. 10,000 minus 100 into 2 is 200, 2 is 400 plus 2 square, 4. So 10,400, 10,000 minus 400 is nothing but 9,600 plus 4 is 9,604. So the value of 98 square is 9,604. Let me go with the fifth question now. The fifth question given is 87 square. So 87 square, can we go nearest to 100 or can we go with 90? Anyhow you can do, children. So 87, since two digit, nearest to the two digit number for 87 is 90. So in 90, what number I have to subtract to get 87? Minus 3. So 90 minus 3 whole square. A minus B whole square is nothing but A square minus 2AB plus B square. So compare, the value of A is 90, the value of B equal to 3. You have like signs, children, here. So value of variable B should be taken in positive only. Substitute, 90 minus 3 whole square equal to A square nothing but 90 square minus 2, A is nothing but 90, B is nothing but 3 plus B square is nothing but 3 square. Then 90 square, 9 square, 81, 102 times. So you'll get 8100 minus 9 2s, or you can go 3 2s, 6 9s, 54. So 540 plus 3 square, 9. Now subtract. So 0 minus 0, 0. Then 10 minus 4 is 6. Then 10, 10 minus 5 is 5. Then 1 given, so 7. 7,560 plus 9. Then you'll get 7,569. This is the value for 87 square. Next, we'll go with the last question. Sixth question, that is 19.9 whole square. Here 19.9, which is nearest to 20. For 20, what I have to subtract so that I get 19.9? So here I'll show you the trick. So since 19.9 is nearest to 20, 20 can be written as 20.0. Then 19.9, if you subtract, then 10 minus 9 is 1 point. Here 9 remains. 9 minus 9 is 0. Here already given 1 minus 1 is 0. That is 0.1. So for 20, if you subtract 0.1, then you will get 19.9 square. So 19.9 whole square can be written as 20 minus 0.1 whole square. So it's in the form of a minus b whole square is nothing but a square minus 2ab plus b square. Then substitute, check, the value of a is 20, the value of b is 0.1. Substitute in the identity, what is left hand side? A minus b, that is 20 minus 0.1 whole square equal to a value is 20 square minus 2 into 20, b value is 0.1 plus 0.1 whole square. 20 square, that is 2 square is 4, single digit 2 times, so 400 minus 22 is a 40, 41 is a 40. After point you have only one decimal, so after point one digit, therefore 1 point plus 1 square is 1, since after decimal point you have one digit, since it is a square 2 times, so 0. That if you write 0 1 is nothing but 1, or 1 is nothing but 1, so 0.01 because 2 digits. Now 400 minus 4 is nothing but 396 plus 0.01 is nothing but 396.01. This is the final answer for the question. So children, so today we have solved worksheet 2 complete, and in the next class we are going to introduce the third identity, and application of third identity also we'll solve in the next session. So thank you, have a nice day children. So please maintain your class notes neatly. Thank you and have a nice day. We'll meet in the next session.